welcome back to my channel. If you didn't know, my name is Iman, or Dancing in Circles, and I make pole, aerial hoop, and lollipop lira tutorials on this channel. So I had a request to cover some more beginner-friendly tutorials on lollipop lira. So today I'm going to be covering one of my favorite beginner lollipop lira sequences. So gear up for that. If you find this video useful, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. It really does help me out with growing this channel. I will also list my Instagram and TikTok over here. Check it out. If you have any requests, feel free to send me a DM. I love to hear them, and please tag me if you try this combo out. And without further ado, let's get into the video. All right, guys, so we're going to be starting this combo from the bottom of our hoop, and we're going to be using our step in entry to get ourselves inside of the bar. So we're going to be using essentially the pole to help us hook our knee inside of the hoop. So to do this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab just above my forehead, and I'm going to go right hand stacked above the left. So now from here, if my right hand is high, my right knee is going to hook inside of the hoop, and I'm going to use my left foot to push onto the pole. So now from here, I'm going to stack my hands. My left foot is going to go onto the pole, and I'm going to bring the arch of my foot onto the pole. So I'm not going to use my toes like a Chinese pole climb, but we're going to use the arch of our foot. So your toes are going to be to one side of the pole, and my heel is going to be pointing down to the opposite side of the pole. Now from here, I don't want to reach my foot too high. We're not going to hike the hip up or anything like that. I'm going to bring it slightly parallel to the ground, maybe a little bit lower is fine. Now from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lock out that knee. So I'm going to get it locked in straight, push into the pole, we're gonna pull up a touch. Now from here, I'm gonna take that back leg, we're gonna bring it inside of the hoop on the same side. We're gonna pull it into the knee pit. Make sure you don't land just on your ankle. Now from here, I'm pretty high, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep my arms bent, chest close to the sidebar. I'm gonna sneak that bottom foot off the pole. And from here, I'm gonna get my ankle to one side and my knee to the opposite side of the pole. Now from here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna push my shin into the pole, slide my leg down. I'm gonna take opposite hands to ankle, and we're gonna drop that knee hook. Now from here, we're going to take that top arm off, and we're gonna go for our stargazer. So from here, you can reach back, open up. Chest should be up, facing the ceiling. Don't turn out this way. Now from here, I'm gonna crunch back up. I'm gonna hook same elbow to knee that's hooked. I'm gonna make sure that that elbow is hooked before I release that knee hook. Now from here, I can take this hand and I can bring it high, just above the forehead. We're gonna sneak that bottom leg off the pole, and I'm gonna get my butt on the pole. Now from here, I'm gonna bring this leg straight up towards my face, and we're gonna grab it with that elbow hooked arm, thumb pointing down. Now from here, I can take that top arm off, and we can open out into our martini sit. So from here, we've got our knee grip, we've got some elbow grip, we've got a trap leg, and we've got some butt grip right on the pole, so you should feel fairly secure in this position to take that top arm off, open the chest out, and we're here in our martini. So this is a nice single knee hook variation to that traditional Delilah that we usually come into when we're first learning. Now from here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reach back up above the forehead, and then I'm going to release the leg. Now from here, we're gonna bind climb to come into the hoop, so I'm gonna sweep that arm back, reach above, sweep the arm back, reach up, crunch up, and from here, I'm gonna extend the leg that's hooked inside of the hoop. Now from here, we're gonna straighten it out. Notice that I turned over, and now I'm on my thigh. So from here, I'm getting my chest right onto that sidebar, the leg that's in the hoop. I'm going to bend. I'm gonna bring it inside of the hoop, and I'm just gonna tag my ankle. Don't flex your foot, you don't need to do this. Keep your toe pointed. We're gonna push the ankle inside of the hoop. Now bottom leg, I'm going to tag onto the pole for a little bit of added security. Now we're in our inside running.
So from here, what I can do is I can arch back in this position, or if I keep my head to the same side of the knee that's inside of the hoop, I can balance so I can take my hands off. Now from here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reach up to about 2 o'clock. I'm gonna take my opposite hand, reach across, and we're gonna sit up facing in the same direction as that knee that's inside of the hoop. So from here, I'm gonna pop that ankle off. We're gonna slide back into the back of the knee. Now I wanna do this because it makes it much easier to bring that free leg back inside of the hoop. So from here, what I can do is I can cross ankles, roll those shoulders back and down, open up the chest, maybe look up. Now from here, we're gonna release, extend the leg, and pull back in. So I just wanna show you if I didn't do that. So if I stayed high on my bum and the bottom bar was like right underneath my bum cheeks, and then I tried to reach that leg in, see how much I have to hike the hip up? So it doesn't look as pretty, it's a little bit uncomfortable, it's a little bit more fumbly. So remember, sliding back into the backs of the knees looks super pretty, open, you can hang out there, it's a beautiful shape, and from there it makes it much easier to pop that leg in and out. Now from here we're gonna go into our stag seat. So I'm gonna turn my hips, I'm gonna bend one leg, and if I'm bending my left leg, I'm going to turn my chest in that direction. I'm gonna extend the opposite leg, we're gonna go toe to knee, and then from here I'm gonna make sure that the bottom bar is right underneath my butt cheeks, and from here I'm gonna go arms in a T behind the hoop. This is our stag. From here, we can tilt the hips and face the opposite direction. Now what I wanna do is we're going to walk back into the opposite shoulder as the knee. So if my knee is pointing to the right, I'm gonna walk down into my left shoulder. Now from here, you can see that I readjusted to make sure that the bottom bar is right underneath, right in between the butt cheeks, so I feel really solid and secure in the seat. And from here, I'm gonna take that outside leg. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring it inside of the hoop and cross it over the thigh. So we're gonna cross the legs over the thigh. And from here, if you feel really secure, I'm gonna push the back of my neck into the side of the hoop. We're gonna squeeze the knee hooks. And from here, you may be able to take your hands off. Now from here, we're gonna transition this into our cradle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my top arm and I'm gonna re-grab just above the forehead. Now from here, I'm gonna take my bottom arm, so opposite hand to shoulder. I'm gonna bring it thumb in behind my back. So thumb pointing in towards my body. From here, I'm gonna push into that bottom arm and pull into the top arm, and we're gonna slide that bottom hip all the way out of the hoop. Now from here, we land in our cradle, so we land back in that same knee hook, that top knee hook. So I keep the heel squeezing in towards the bum because we want to keep that knee hooked position. Now from here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn my chest inside of the hoop. It's a very small turn, and so I'm just gonna face my mirror, or sorry, my window. Now from here, what I can do is I can go arms out in a T, and we're going to extend the leg inside of the hoop, push the back of the knee down into the bar. And that will make you feel much more secure in this position for our star in the bar. Now from here, I'm gonna rehook that leg. I'm gonna take my top arm, so same arm as the shoulder that I'm on, and I'm going to go reach inside of the hoop, thumb pointing up towards 12 o'clock. So from here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sneak that bottom shoulder out of the hoop. Now I can extend the leg that's inside of the hoop, and do the same thing, push the back of the knee down into the bar for an arabesque with my chest facing the hoop. Now from here, you can either drop your bottom leg down or we can bring them together. Now from here, I'm gonna take my free hand, I'm gonna rehook that leg, I'm gonna grab back, face level. Now from here, I'm gonna take that top arm off, and we're gonna arch down for a Delilah. Now from here, I can reach back up, pull my chest up towards the bar, unhook the knee, and we can step out. And there is your beginner combo.